area specific forecast in Uttarakhand as of today. Let's start with Gangotri. Now that's an area that is likely to see 30 to 60 mm of rainfall today. After that, let's move on to Yamunotri, and that too is likely to see heavy rainfalls today. Moving on to Kedarnath, remember this area has been completely evacuated as of now, but authorities still fear that there could be people around this area who could still be trapped. And finally, let's talk about Badrinath. Rainfalls expected here as well, and it is expected that about 5,000 people are still in Badrinath who are stranded. Remember, the focus was on Kedarnath, and after that the focus was supposed to shift to Badrinath. So all the activities are likely to take place today to move all these 5,000 people out of Badrinath. Aditi Anant Narayanan is now joining us with the latest details from Dehradun. Aditi, take us through the rescue operations that are likely to take place today. We understand that the weather is inclement, but what are the authorities saying is the way out, because people still stranded, about 15,000 of them?
Maha, the news isn't very good. In fact, today morning the choppers had taken off from the Sahasrdhara helipad in Dehradun, and as you can see, all the choppers are now back. The sky, if I can just ask my camera person Ritesh to just pan, you can see it is almost black out here. The clouds are coming towards this side. They are moving up across Uttarakhand, making it extremely difficult for the rescue team to actually go ahead and go carry on with the operation. Today they were concentrating on moving towards Harsil, Badrinath and Kedarnath. And many of these choppers had actually flown off. They had left the helipad, but they had to come back from Devprayag because of poor visibility. And for the moment, they are all the helicopters are grounded. They will be waiting for the weather to clear up, and only then, after probably an hour or so, they will take a weather check. They will probably attempt to go there. And today morning also, there was an attempt, but sadly the attempt was a failure. And right now the choppers are here. The rescue mission has been put on hold. Thousands still stranded across Uttarakhand, Maha. So very difficult times are for in the future to see. And the Met Department has also predicted that there will be heavy rainfall till at least 30th of June. So even the captains out here, the pilots are out here, the army officials are just hoping and praying that the weather clears up soon, so that at least within a window of 2 or 3 hours they can get as many people as possible, Maha.
All right, and some more bad news in fact coming in. The operations are being held hostage by the fact that two major landslides have also taken place in Sonprayag and Bhatta region. In fact, as Aditi was pointing out, their rains are causing havoc again today. Our reporters are panned across Uttarakhand, and they are getting us the latest reports from ground zero. Let's take a look at that now.
The relief and rescue operations through air have been suspended because of overcast conditions. Though in the upper side of the mountains, it is very cloudy, but it's still holding on. People, those who have been walking on foot, might be facing some trouble because of the rain, and that has loosened the soil. And so, as of now, the Indian Air Force and the rescuers are trying to evacuate as many as people from Harsil. Officers have told us that there are still about 400 people stuck there, and in the villages between Gangotri, Gomukh, Harsil and Maneri, there are still thousands of those who are stuck and trying to make their way to safety, to Uttarkashi, from these mountains. This will be a daunting task, and everybody was praying that if the weather holds on in the next day or two, people, those who have been stranded for the last 7 to 8 days, can be brought to safety. With camera person Sudhir, Ankit Tyagi for Headlines Today.
Very critical day here at the Gauchar airfield for the Indian Air Force chopper operations. The news is not good. Ever since last night, it's been raining very, very heavily. And what that has meant is all the choppers are stranded at the Gauchar airfield. Now, perhaps in some hours from now, a chopper would be sent out to do some recce of the area. But before that happens, the entire chopper fleet would remain stranded. Mind you, even till today, the army and the air force accept there are thousands of pilgrims who are still stranded. But they maintain, because of the massive relief and rescue effort, all those pilgrims have at least been dropped food packets and given essential medical aid. But airlifting those pilgrims today could be a Herculean task, that on account of the fact the weather today is not very good. So as of now, for the IAF, it's simply a wait and watch game. With camera person Madan Prasad, this is Pankaj Upadhyay in Gochar Airfield for headlines today.
Relief and rescue work has been going on in Kedarnath, Gaurikund and Guptkashi for the last several days, but it looks unlikely that any kind of rescue or relief work will carry on today. Right now I am in Guptkashi and I can show you at the information center, lots and lots of vehicles are standing here, and many pilgrims who were brought from Kedarnath and Gaurikund, they have been staying here all night, and they'll be taken from here, they'll be taken to Rudraprayag and Dehradun and Rishikesh, to various places where they want to go. But as far as weather is concerned, it's a bad day today. It has been raining since last night, and if I could ask my cameraman to just show in the hills, there's dense fog cover, clouds, there's a lot of clouds here, so it is looking unlikely in the day that any choppers of the Indian Air Force will be flying to Kedarnath or Gaurikund or Jangal Chatti to rescue people and to other people also who are stranded in lot of places in the jungles. It's a Met Department has already forecasted that it will be raining in this area for next 3 to 4 days, and it has already started raining. Weather is bad and the weather is not suitable for any choppers of the Indian Air Force to move to the higher altitudes and rescue people. With camera person Harish Kanpal, this is Rohit Singh in Guptkashi for headlines today.